crossroads of the Pakistan economy are situated along the Indus River. Diversified economies of Karachi and Punjab's urban centers coexist with lesser developed areas in other parts of the country, including the relatively lesser developed southern Punjab. This also includes the districts of Muzaffargarh, Laya and Rajanpur. In July 2010, heavy floods caused devastation across Pakistan. With one-fifth of Pakistan's total land area underwater, these floods directly affected about 20 million people. The destruction of property, livelihood, and infrastructure was monumental, with the death toll close to 2,000. Unable to cope with the natural disaster, the economy took a serious blow. All the indicators were negative. The GDP growth rate was forecasted to come down from minus 2% to minus 5%. As a result, the existing $55 billion of external debt was also set to grow. Crop losses were expected to cause food insecurity and decline in exports. Billions of dollars worth of infrastructure, including roads, bridges, railroad tracks, and buildings were destroyed. In the flood-affected areas of southern Punjab, economic livelihood of an entire people was severely impacted. And there was a genuine threat that a large majority of people would be pushed below the poverty line. In the hour of need, Plan Pakistan launched flood relief initiatives and rehabilitation efforts. It set about to provide monetary assistance to flood affectees by creating jobs. The end result was a unique program called Cash for Work. Cash for Work projects focus on providing short-term income and employment opportunities to the poorest and the most vulnerable families, including households run by women, while simultaneously rehabilitating and strengthening the physical infrastructure in flood-affected villages. Cash for Work program helped displaced families gain access to basic amenities and household goods through guaranteed employment and income earning opportunities for a minimum period of 30 days. It was launched as a joint initiative of Plan Pakistan and Plan Sweden. To ensure maximum efficiency and effectiveness, a solid criteria was devised and followed. Selecting a village, forming a CFW committee, selecting a participant, assigning the work on mutually agreed payment terms. Villages that were hit the worst were identified. Damage was further assessed through repeated field visits. Areas which were least served, least deployed in terms of infrastructure, where people were socially, economically and politically deprived, and where poverty was high according to the poverty index tool, were prioritized. Areas where people were willing to work and where no security threats existed for the staff were identified. According to the criteria, 27 villages were identified, out of which 25 villages located in 6 tehsils and 12 union councils of 3 districts. Muzaffargarh, Laya and Rajanpur were finalized for the CFW program. Communities were mobilized and CFW committees were organized to ensure community ownership and implementation. Roles and responsibilities of stakeholders were clearly designated. Workers were chosen from different families through a transparent process and selection criteria. Participants should reside in a flood-affected village, should be willing to work in a group, ready to work for 6 or 7 days per week, for wages between Pakistani rupees 300 to 600. On 25 CFW schemes, a total number of 2,835 laborers worked for a minimum period of 30 days each. About 497 women also did manual labor along with men. Most of them were sole bread earners in their houses.
ਤੇ ਸਾਰਾ ਅੱਛਾ ਜ਼ਿੰਦਗੀ ਤੇ ਗੁਜ਼ਰਦੇ ਬੱਚਿਆਂ ਦਾ ਇਲਾਜ ਵੀ ਕਰਾ ਗਿੰਦੇ ਆ ਤੇ ਆਪਣਾ ਵੀ ਇਲਾਜ ਕਰਾ ਗਿੰਦੇ ਆ ਤੇ ਇੱਥੇ ਸਕੂਂ ਦੁਆਬਾ ਕੰਪਨੀ ਦੇ ਤਰਫੋਂ ਤੇ ਪਲਾਨ ਦੇ ਤਰਫੋਂ ਪੈਸੇ ਵੀ ਮਿਲ ਵੈਨੇ ਮਜ਼ਦੂਰੀ ਤੇ ਅਸਾਂ ਇੱਥੇ ਕੰਮ ਖੜੇ ਕਰਨ ਸਕ ਬਹੁਤ ਖੁਸ਼ੀ ਹੈ
सन 2000 फ्लड आए, सारे पुल टूट गए। ये पुल दुआबा फाउंडेशन पलाने पाकिस्तान आन के था काम करने पे। सारा रोजगार का मसला है, वो भी सारा थीना पे, रास्ता भी बहाल थीना पे। सारे बच्चे स्कूल वैसन, अस्पताल वैस, कोई मसला होसी जल्दी पहुँचू। सवारी का मसला है, सवारी भी जल्दी आसी जासी।
जिमें एक सारी बीबी को बच्चा पैदा थी मना है, तो को सारा दिन रखी खड़े रह गया से, कोई शायद कह नहीं ना हूँ को असा ने सकते हाँ से कि नहीं, तो ना कोई आ सकता असा कने, कोई डॉक्टर कोई नर्स कोई ना आ सकता। उनको सदा दरेड़े ते चाक ते कोट मिठान गया से, सारे 5 घंटे लग गया उत्ते ताणी वेंदे वेंदे। हूँ तो माशाला साढ़े रस्ते बन गए, असा वन सकसूँ। हूँ तो सारा मरीज कार ते भी वन सकसे, हूँ तो सारे असा कने डॉक्टर भी आ सकसे। असा शुक्र गुजार हूँ हर प्लान पाकिस्तान दे।
Payment to workers was made on a weekly basis. An attendance sheet was prepared on daily basis for payment of wages. So far, around 18.05 million rupees have been dispersed among the laborers.
The basic purpose of this project to provide a short-term employment to the vulnerable and poor families, and also to rehabilitate the physical infrastructure of these villages which are devastated by the flood.
So after the floods, the main essence was that people are able to stand on their own feet and the children are benefited. So for this, this cash for work scheme was good in the sense that people could go back to their homes, and instead of having a dole out approach and waiting for people, they were relying on their own hands, and they could help themselves to rebuild their lives quicker and in the safety of their own homes. The children benefit in the sense that the parents were able to gain livelihood in their own communities, and they were safe because we had planned and set up daycare centers and child friendly spaces for the children, where the parents or the women who were working in these projects could leave their children with the comfort that they would be safe and they would be looked after, gain employment and come back and help rebuild their own lives.
Addressing the pressing issue of food security, the program succeeded in creating job opportunities for 2,300 flood affectees. In Muzaffargarh, rupees 7.88 million were dispersed to 1,269 workers through 8 CFW schemes. In Laya, rupees 4.005 million were dispersed to 866 workers through 8 CFW schemes. In Rajanpur, rupees 6.18 million was dispersed to 700 workers through 9 CFW schemes. What's more, daycare centers were opened for children while their mothers were away at work. Child protection personnel were identified and trained accordingly.
Glenn has been working in Pakistan for the past 15 years. We're also, this is another milestone that we're celebrating this in 2012, is the 75th anniversary of Plan International. Both of these milestones will be celebrating in 2012. In particular, this project for Cash for Work, this is the first time we've had an opportunity in Pakistan to actually implement a project of this stature. Prior to the floods of 2010, Plan didn't have a lot of experience working in Cash for Work. But with the help of an international consultant and our Swedish national organization, we were able to successfully actually, I think, implement this project and give benefit to about 20,000 families in the flood affectees of 2010. And for instance, we're very appreciative to all the support we've had from our partners, from our national organizations, and of course, the beneficiaries of this project, which are women and children, and of course, men.
Plan's Cash for Work project has had a wide impact on communities looking to rebuild their lives. Entire villages have been able to sustain themselves as the painful and enduring chapter of rehabilitation continues. Infrastructural development is underway, creating better access to the marketplace and hospitals. Children can finally go back to school again. Cash disbursement was temporary, but restoration of community physical infrastructure was permanent feature that the community could own and benefit from. Necessary tools and equipment were purchased and distributed among workers and were not taken back even after the end of the assignments. Labor who provided services would be able to perform such type of work anywhere else very skillfully. Female would be empowered when they have cash in their hands. Community will be enabling to access to main cities easily, and agricultural crops could be transported to cities due to which their livelihood will sustain. In case of emergency or any patient could be brought to hospital in time and life could be saved. Children will go to school even in rainy weather. Above all, the spirit to rebuild was permanently built among the people and communities. The people learned that every suffering is temporary. What is permanent is the will to rebuild, the will to restart life in a new way.